May, it was like the first week of May in 2013, I went to my normal CF doctor appointment. It's like every 3 months, get checked up on, and this one was a little different. She told me that I was not getting better and it was time to get me ready to be evaluated for double lung transplant. It's just hard to think that it's gonna be okay at that point. You're dying. That's what they're saying. You're dying and you need new lungs.
I want to survive, and if a transplant is how I survive, I'm doing it. Let's do it. So on March 12th, 2014, I was listed for a double lung transplant.
Wait, almost there, almost. I keep going for you then.
I started YouTube because my Lungs for TIFF campaign went viral and I wanted people to know what I go through on the daily basis, not just seeing my picture and reading my story like that. I wanted people to get into real life of cystic fibrosis. I was able to meet a whole bunch of people. And one relationship that really benefited my life was Leah.
Leah was very fortunate to be very internet savvy. Started following a young lady on the West Coast. It was Lungs for TIFF, and Leah began to follow her. And then they began to get to know each other, and they used to Skype and do FaceTime. And I can tell you, there would be times when Leah was on IVs and she'd be carrying her computer around. It would be Tiffany with her.
We could relate to each other 100%.
So it's hospital time still, and I am having a good day, actually. I feel a little bit better, still coughing. And I got my FaceTime date, Leah, today. Hey, girl. Doing her nebs. Good CF for right there. Yeah, we're just having a good girls' night. Yeah.
A million miles away.
A million miles away.
Really, one of the more challenging parts is that we really can't be together. So a lot of people with CF, including me, we all develop these very deep, ingrained relationships really through the internet.
It's isolating. When you have cystic fibrosis, I mean, you think of all these other diseases that don't have this aspect. They can go and have support groups together. With CF, I mean, we can hurt each other. But the good thing with technology is that we have social media. You need that connection with someone. You need to be able to talk about it. And the people around you, you can only talk to them about so much.
Leah could understand when Tiffany was having a hard time. She could understand when I was having a hard time. And I think Leah always had the right words in the right moment. That, I think, is what made Leah such a valuable part of the friendship for Tiffany.
And so Tiff and Leah supported themselves through both of their journeys and both of their struggles via Skype, talking.
So it's November 29th. It's about 4:30 in the morning. I got the call for lungs.
About a couple months before transplant, I was starting to feel very, very ill. After 2 years and 8 months of waiting on the list, I got one call. I remember getting on the table, and then I went to bed, and I woke up with new lungs. It was amazing.
Good girl. So proud of you. Look at you.
Leah actually reached out to me, like out of the middle of nowhere. She was trying to make a video of a bunch of people with CF to support Tiffany through the recovery of her transplant.
That video, I kid you not, got me through it. It just helped me know that I'm not in it alone.
Tiff, the day finally happened. You finally got those new lungs you've been waiting so long for. And I couldn't be more happy or more proud of you. I absolutely hate more than anything that I physically can't be there for you during one of the most exciting times of your life, but definitely the most difficult time. So I figured I'd put this short video together for you to show you just how much your positive spirit affects so many people in the CF community and just how many of us are rooting for you.
Tiff got lungs!
The hashtag
Lungs for Tiff has now turned into Tiff Got Lungs.
Eventually meet. They meet twice, and that was on Leah's bucket list.
Like, how awesome would that be to meet your best friend?
We had to get doctor approval to make sure that we didn't jeopardize Tiffany, who's transplanted and immunosuppressed, and Leah, who may have something, although stable at the time, not to affect her.
So Disney World was our place. We had always talked about Disney World because Disney is just a place where you feel happy. And I'm looking. My mom spots her. And she's like, Tiff, she's right over there. And I start running. I cry every time I watch that video. Every time. It was the best day ever. And I, we wanted to help people. So we both decided on Salty Cysters. We wanted to show people our lives and that CF doesn't have to define you.
And she knew in order to do that, she had to tell her story. It took a lot of courage for her to do it, and she did it.
But I realized that you are your biggest advocate, but you're also an advocate when it comes to raising money for a cure, spreading awareness.
Together, they created this like amazing brand.
We needed to show that it's a grueling disease. It's scary. There's an unknown about it, but this is how we handle it. And you can do it too.
Based on what they were doing with the Salty Cysters, they were obviously having a really amazing impact. And I felt the need to really amplify what they were doing.
He wanted Lee and I to be on a podcast, and we loved the idea, and of course we wanted to get involved with Boomer Esiason Foundation, so we started doing that, and we had such a blast.
Hi everyone, it's Leah Ferrone, and I'm joined with my lovely co-hosts, Gunnar Esiason and Tiffany Rich.
I had a hard time initially like getting some words in, because they were always just so willing to build off whatever the other one was talking about. You know, they just wanted to be able to show the general public what it was like to live with CF, you know, outside the lens of, you know, what the mainstream idea of CF may seem like.
Looking healthy is something Leah did well. I think a lot of people didn't even realize much about the illness.
Leah loved to go on trips. We tried to plan trips every 2 years. So this was our Italy trip.
Then she came back and had an infection, normal. We didn't think anything of it. And then it just wasn't going away.
She seemed to be okay and seemed like she was getting through it, but then she developed this cough that was a worse cough. So we went back in to see the physician and he admitted her, which was right around Thanksgiving.
Fairly quickly, she was getting sicker and sicker.
I know Tiffany was pretty distraught as Leah got sicker and sicker, and she didn't know what to do because Leah had done so much for her when Tiffany was sick that it was very difficult to watch.
Because this illness can show a side so fast, so drastic, that you don't have a chance.
When she went into the hospital for the last time, a lot of people didn't really visit because I think they thought she would be out in 2 weeks, you know.
Leah was up in the ICU, and that night she had a difficult night. She seemed to be progressing. Everybody thought doing a little bit better, thought we were start to changing. And then she ran into another issue, and unfortunately she didn't make it through. So I called my husband and my daughter back, and we were with her.
We didn't even think that was gonna happen, to be honest. It was so fast. That was the hardest thing to even like wrap my head around, that she's not here anymore. And I didn't want to believe it.
We were all surprised. Life expectancy was supposed to be so much longer. And Leah was always ahead of the game. what you have to learn is you can't let your guard down at all. You have to always fight for more.
And she did say on the podcast once that, you know, her greatest fear living with CF was leaving everyone else behind.
I wasn't able to even say goodbye to her. I didn't get that goodbye. And I didn't get to tell her that I love her and that I was so proud of her.
I would thank her. I would tell her how honored I was to be her parent.
She's a gift. She's so humble. She carried a message far beyond anyone ever believed, and she wanted to do more. And I wish she could.
You know, it was probably one of the worst days of my life. And it was just, it was like being hit by a freight train.
It made me realize that cystic fibrosis is unpredictable. It's personalized. It doesn't care. It just wants to kill you.
We were overwhelmed with the response of how many lives she touched. I mean, it was international. We had no idea. And this is where she says she took her weakness, which was cystic fibrosis, and she made it her strength.
You know, I feel so blessed that I still have her voice on my computer.
I'm genuinely happy with how my life is. Like, you know, it'd be nice if I didn't have CF, but it has made me a better person. And
you've met people that you'd probably never would have had you not
right.
had CF.
You know, and like, they're some of my best friends, and it's weird because like, if I didn't have it, I wouldn't have met them.
The Boomer Esiason Foundation is impacting our community like no other.
They have done such an amazing job because they're going to the root of the problems. How they've affected people personally, we know. We know not only from Leah and Salty Cysters and podcasts, but now the scholarship, now getting the Courage Award. How do I say this? Their foundation is real.
I'm thrilled to death that Leah's being honored.
When I received the letter that Leah and I were receiving the Michael Brennan Courage Award, I couldn't believe it. I got the goosebumps. I was just in shock.
I just cried. If anybody deserves it, it's what Leah and Tiff tried to do. Tried to bring the awareness, and I'm so proud that Leah is getting that award. I'm so proud. I just wish she was here.
If you talk about, you know, Leah or Tiffany, you know, anyone you talk to that has CF knows who they are, what they've done, and what they mean for the community. And I think we at Boomer Esiason Foundation feel the responsibility to make sure that we are amplifying that message forever.
We look at all these new drugs, and they're amazing, but they're not a cure. My hopes for the future for CF are I want people to be able to go live life and live like Leah did, live like I do, live and do things that they love.
I think what you learn from Leah's life is that you live every day to its fullest, live every day as if it's your last day, do something happy every day for yourself.
To keep Leah alive, I'll keep on doing Salty Cysters, and we've always wanted to just keep the community unified. I think that's just what I intend to do. Just always talk about her, because she'll always be alive with me.
I will fight for you. I always do until my heart is black and blue.